Well, I want you to turn with me in your Bibles this morning in the book of Hebrews, chapter 2. Hebrews, chapter 2, looking at verses 1 through 3. The title of my message this morning, Are You Drifting? Springtime is here, and a lot of us, go out on the inner tubes and down the rivers and lakes and streams, and we drift along on those inner tubes. There are times when we may be swimming along in the ocean, and all of a sudden, we start drifting out to sea because an undercurrent has taken us out. Oftentimes in the spiritual realm, too, there's a time that we start drifting. We'll drift away from the things of the Lord. And we have to be very careful because drifting can end up in danger zone, if you will. It can end up harming you or hurting you or destroying you. So you have to be very careful on how you drift. And this morning in the book of Hebrews in chapter 2 in verses 1 through 3, the Bible said, therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we should let them slip or they drift away from us. For if the world was spoken by angels was steadfast, and every transgression and disobedience received a just recompense of reward. And the writer said, how shall we escape if we neglect so great salvation, which at the first began to be spoken by the Lord and was confirmed unto us by them that heard him? In other words, the Bible is telling us here, take heed to what we have heard. And what have we heard this morning already through song? We have heard the Word of God. Now, we have heard the Word of God being preached to us time after time. The Bible says then we need to take heed to that Word, lest at any time it slips away from us. And especially as a believer in Jesus Christ, as a person who has been born again into the family of God. You need to take earnest heed to what God is telling you through His Word. And I trust that each and every one of you who are born again believer this morning are reading the Word of God each day and praying to Him. And in your prayer and quiet time when you're reading and studying the Word of God, I'm praying that you are listening to the voice of God. And I hope you take heed as the writer is warning here. You better take heed to it and you better do what it says or else we would have to give an account to God for our deeds here on this earth. Whether good or bad, the Bible said, we'll one day stand before God. And so we need to take heed to what God is telling us because it is so easy to drift away from what the Word of God tells us to do. Drifting actually requires no effort on our part. Little effort is given in drifting. But to go against the tide, to go against the current, it takes a tremendous effort. And certainly there's a lot of things in this world that can undercurrent us and take us drifting away from God, isn't it? There's a lot of things in this world that can occupy our mind, that'll keep us adrift. But to defeat those things requires an effort on our part. First of all, listening to what God says and asking Him for His help to oar against the current that is pulling us away. And bring us back to an anchor that is true and honest and will hold us, and that anchor is Jesus Christ. Sometimes drifting not only doesn't require any effort on our part, but is an unconscious process. And how does that happen, preacher? Well, I want to tell you, this morning, sometimes you can stay at home for various reasons from the house of God. Thank God you didn't this morning. But there may be coming a time in the near future that the devil will pop something up in your mind and says, well, I got to do this or I got to do that, or you're just too tired. Don't go. You worked hard. And especially on Wednesday nights, that ain't Sunday morning, so just stay at home. You don't need that Bible study, so just stay at home. And unconsciously, you just do it naturally, and you stay at home, and all of a sudden, you're drifting away from the things of God. And you said, preacher, well, I don't see that in the Bible that I got to be there every time. The Bible says in Hebrews 10:25, forsake not the assembling of yourselves together. We need one another. We need one. I need you. You need me, hopefully. Amen. I know I need you. I hope you know you need me. We all need each other. Because, see, we all are subject, amen, to drift. And if you're drifting, honey, you'd be appreciative if somebody would put you back, amen, in the safety zone, if you will. I know sometimes when you're swimming at the ocean there and the undercurrent takes you on out, and you thank God for that lifeguard that's on duty out there watching you and seeing that you're being towed out to sea and goes after you and bring you back in. Or else, adios, you out of here, huh? But thank God for the lifesavers. And each one of us are accountable to one another, and we help one another. If we fall in the category of drifting, another can pull us back, and vice versa. When we see one stumble, hey man, we should not put them down, but lift them up. Bring them back, amen, unto the safety zone of God. It's great mercy and love for us. Because we all are subject to drift. And guess what? We never drift upstream. We always drift down. You ever thought about that? But let me tell you, friend, when you're drifting, it's too late when you hear the waterfall to do anything about it. So let's do it, amen, before we get there. Let's correct it. Let's go back to the safety zone. The speed downstream also increases. We can miss one service, it's easy to miss another. And another. And another. How you know you're drifting? When you lose a desire to be in the house of God. When you lose a desire to be in the house of God. And why do you lose a desire to be in the house of God? Because, see, another undercurrent is taking you away from reading the Word of God and studying it and praying to God on a daily basis. That's how you know you're drifting. When you lose the love for God and His Word. How many of you ever fell in love in here? Just raise your hand if you will. I mean, just give me a... I like people to just show me something. Amen. How many of you been in love? How many are you in love now? Woo. When you're in love, or think you're in love. Let's put it that way too. You do anything for that individual you done fell in love with. Amen? Amen. Can I get a witness? Amen. And some of you can't wait to talk to them. How many of you were like that? After you got married, you quit talking. Man, you couldn't wait till you get home, pick up the telephone. Maybe he just dropped you out. You couldn't give him time to get home. What you doing? Now you got cell phones. You talk all the way home. Huh? You couldn't wait to communicate and be with that individual. I used to couldn't wait till Friday night come. Friday night, date night. Rush home early. Wash your car. Wax it. Clean it up for my baby to slide in the seat. Hello? Why? Because I would do anything for that individual that I was in love with. Or thought I was in love with. Y'all won't say it, but I'll say it, all right? We'd do anything. But when have we ever fell in love with God? Have you ever fell in love with God? And if you fell in love with God and He saved your soul, your love should be, amen, rekindled each day. You know what I'm saying here? Your fire should still be burning, honey. A desire to be with Him. A desire to communicate with Him. The desire to hear His sweet voice speaking in your ear. A desire, amen, to walk with Him and to talk with Him and to have that sweet fellowship. And the only way that you and I will ever get close to God is right here, friend. For this is God. John tells us that in chapter 1. This is God. And when you lose a desire to speak to Him and to open His Word up and let Him whisper those sweet nothings in your ear. When you lose that desire, your love is dying. And you are drifting away. And when you lose that desire, it'll keep you from the house of God. It'll keep you from associating with your brothers and sisters in the Lord. It will, amen, and you keep on drifting. After a while, nothing affects you any longer. You have no desire to be where you are today. And friend, I want to warn you, and I want to give you a heed this morning, because every one of us in this building are subject to drift at times. But we don't have to stay adrift. We can, amen, oar back to the safety zone. We can roar against the stream, current, amen, that is pulling us away. We can go upstream. Because greater is He that is in us than he that is in the world. I got a motor, amen. It's called Holy Ghost motor, amen. It's high powered. It's powered, amen, by the fuels of heaven. It's able to pull me, amen, into the safety zone of God's loving arms and care. So when you see a desire in your heart for God's Word and His house and being with His people, then friend, you are in that safety zone. But if you see it going in the opposite direction, you are drifting this morning. And let me tell you, friend, we are seeing a lot of drifting in our churches. We're drifting away from the truths of this book. This morning, preachers sometimes won't preach what I'm going to tell you. A lot of times now, they're compromised and they're saying it's okay. Mainstream denominations are saying it's okay. It's becoming mainstream and amen in everything that we undertake to do. And that is same-sex marriages, same-sex couples. The Bible said it's wrong and it's against nature. And friend, when we allow it in the church, then we are drifting. We are drifting far from the truths of this book. You said, "Oh, you're preaching hate." No, I'm not preaching hate. God loves the sinner and you're a sinner. If you participate in those type of situations, then friend, you are a sinner. Just as a drunkard is a sinner. Just as a liar is a sinner. And just as anything else is a sin. You are participating, amen, in sin. You are fulfilling the lust of the flesh. And I don't care what anybody says, because the book said it's wrong. And you can't tell me that God, our Creator, amen, messed your mind up when He gave you birth, amen, into this world. My mama gave me birth. Well, God bless her, amen. But God put you there. Hello? And God don't mess up. He made me a man, and I'm still a man. He made you a man or a woman, and He was exactly the way He wanted you to be created. You weren't born with a desire to fulfill the lust of the flesh. That's all you're doing. Hello? Ooh, I told you it wouldn't be popular preaching, amen, in today's pulpit, and you probably won't hear it, amen, in any others. Maybe far and few between. But friend, let me tell you, I'm going to give you the truth of the Word of God. You can take it and do whatever you want to with it. But until we get it right, God cannot bless us, and God cannot bring us, amen, back into His safety zone. And we'll stay adrift, 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 and we're wondering why in the world that our country is in the shape it is in and the world's in the shape it's in. It's because we are of our disobedience and because we are drifting and we are compromising the Word of God. And we can't compromise truth. The Bible said the truth will set you free, and the only way you can be set free is in Jesus Christ. Hello? You let me tell you how we got there. I'm going to just break it out. Amen. I'm going to load the two shells in the shotgun and fire both barrels. All right. I'm going to tell you how we got there. We got there because parents in the church started drifting.